and a beautification.
It's how we play.
Let's take a look at the highlights of their innings. Karen Powell starting positively, a straight six off Mohammad Hafeez. Johnson Charles, a bit of luck here with the outside edge for four. And then falling to Krishna Santokhi. Santokhi, the leading wicket taker in the tournament. And once again, enjoying more success. Powell, boundary backward of square. And here, a difficult chance to Lendl Simmons coming in from mid-on. Marlon Samuel seemed to be in the mood for something special today. Six over backward point. Karen Powell, meanwhile, looking as serene as ever with the four. And then Samuel taking a liking to a Veerasamy Perumal. Consecutive sixes. The second flat and powerful. And even the outside edge helping him here. Slashing for four. And at this stage, they were really racing along. Powell capitalizing on this full toss. But Samuel looking to clear long off, miscuing. And James Franklin taking the catch. Christopher Barnwell with the important breakthrough. Powell continued to swing for the boundaries with success, but was then deceived by the change of pace of the very effective Krishna Santokhi. Ben Rora came in, certainly set about the bowling, as did Devon Thomas. Six over long on. Rora following suit. The left-hander getting into stride. And then a high full toss, a no ball, swatted away for a six as well. And an even bigger one, the most expensive over of the tournament. 24 runs coming off it from Barnwell. But then a curious dismissal here. They thought they had gotten the overthrow, but then you look at this again. Devon Thomas clearly looking to get in the path of the throw, even though he actually didn't. It was determined that he had made a deliberate effort to obstruct the field, and he was given out. Kimar Roach gone for his ball, another wicket for Santokhi. And then looking for a second run of the final delivery, Sheldon Cottrell found short of his ground, and 166 for six the total. So Powell 47, Samuels 43, and the Hawks Bills a competitive total here, 166 for six.
Let's have a look at the highlights of this second part of the game. It really was sensational. This is Martin Guptill. Now, they always play so well right at the start. The Warriors, they've got great confidence in this opening pair. They got away nicely. A couple of nice shots from Guptill, also from Simmons. And that got the run rate going right at the start. And that was a nasty one. That was Cottrell wrapping him on the glove and had retired hurt in the end. So I'll have to keep a close eye on that injury to see how things are deep in the tournament. This is a drop catch. Griffith, it was put down by Kemar Roach. Gee, we had some action. Everything was happening. Magnificent shot, that one from Simmons for six. And this was a really good catch from Rora. It was in the air for a long time. Judged it beautifully. The wind dragged it back a bit and took a fine grab. This was the very next ball, by the way. In the air also. Underneath it was Cottrell this time. We got a salute out of him as well. We're not disappointed with those. So a couple of wickets in two balls certainly changed things. Now, James Franklin also changed things. That was a little paddle shot for six over the keeper. And he decided that he wasn't going to waste any time, and he had an ally. And Mohammad Hafeez, this was a really important partnership. Good swing on the leg side, another boundary. Would have been a brilliant catch had him been taken. There was quite a deviation. Not too short, that one. But rocking on the back foot and hammering that into the crowd. And this was where some big overs happened. Mohammad Hafeez decided he was going to launch as well. Another half a dozen runs. And this was superb from Ponting. We wanted to know, was this the turning point? Franklin found short by a couple of inches only. We've seen Ponting do that for years and years and years. Barnwell arrived. Slap one through the covers for four. Mohammad Hafeez, a little paddle, he's perfected that shot these days, plays it beautifully, plays it with great control, and that was slapped a long way. Kemar Roach in the game at long on. Barnwell did a good job, 16 off a dozen balls, kept the run rate gettable. There was still some work to be done, and Ben Brora will just think, goodness me, I should have taken that. Ronnie Sarwan arrived in the middle, and this was terrific stuff to get back. It was the first delivery of the last over, and first ball Narine faced. He decided to hammer that into the crowd. Curtly liked it, why wouldn't he? And the pressure was really on Thomas at this stage, and he bowled a poor delivery. That was the second last delivery of the game that went for six. Scores were level, and he pumped it for four, and the celebrations began for the Warriors. An outstanding night of cricket, and it knocked the Hawksbills out.
So celebrations among the Guyanese spectators here, and there are quite a few. Hawksbills 166 for 6. They go out. The Amazon Warriors have beaten them 170 for 5. It's how we play.
When the stadium ram beach at the grandstand, got the meaning of beautification.
It's how we play.